والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome you back to the Islamic financial system, to the شركة الملك. What is شركة الملك? شركة الملك is co-ownership. Means you want to buy any asset, maybe a building, maybe piece of land, maybe aircraft, maybe any factory. You want to buy, but you don't have the price, the full price of that asset. You will go to the Islamic bank. Ask the Islamic bank to enter. Suppose that you have 20% of the price. You will ask the bank to add 80%, and with 100%, you will go and to buy the asset. After you purchase the asset, you and the bank, you will become co-owners. Co-owners means you own the house or the asset together. Pro rata. In this case, of course, you paid 10%, you will own 10%. You own 20%, then you will have ownership of 20%. If you pay 50%, your share of the ownership will be 50%. In another words, you will own the asset pro rata. But when you come to distribute the profit, in this sharikat milk, the profit should be distributed pro rata, not as agreed. Means if you pay 50%, you will get 50% of the profit. But what the Islamic banks do? They do something, in my opinion, very good. And that's why customers are happy to come to enter into sharikat milk with the Islamic bank. The bank appoints you as agent, service agent, to take care of the asset, to lease the asset and to collect rental, to fix the asset if it needs maintenance, to carry out insurance on the asset. Because the bank, as we know, has no individuals to run after these things. Means if you enter into sharikat milk with the bank and you own the asset, the bank will appoint you as service agent to take care on the bank behalf. Fees for that. This is the case. Not only fees, the bank may tell you that look here, although you own 50% of the asset and your share of profit is only 50%, but if you manage the asset the right way, and if the return, the profit for me is that much, say 6%, 8%, I'll give you the excess as incentive. What does it mean? That means that always the bank wants the customer to be comfortable, even under this kind of sharikat milk, co-ownership, in which I said that you will get only profit pro rata to your contribution. But the bank, the practice always is like that, that you are appointed as agent, service agent, to carry services, to take care of the asset. If it is ship, for example, if it is plant, if it is aircraft, if it is refinery, anything, it is building even, or group of buildings, you enter into musharaka, but you will get more always. Always you will get more. In the first kind of sharika, what we call it sharika ta'aqd, contractual sharika, we have seen that you may agree with the bank to get a percentage of the profit higher more than your contribution. This is clear. But only in this contractual musharka that you can get more than your share of the contribution. Even in this sharikat milk, the remedy is there. The same treatment, the same advantage that you will be appointed as the service agent to manage the asset and to get more than your share. Musharka has played a great role in the Islamic world and even outside the Muslim world. And a new kind of musharka now is very, very famous. And most of the customers, the clients, they are willing to have this kind of musharka. What is that? This is the musharka, contractual musharka, when you have some asset, some like piece of land, and you want to construct a project, full project, the land to construct infrastructure, and after that to build these buildings. What you will do after you enter into musharka with the bank, and the project is completed, if it is infrastructure, construction, anything, after that, you will agree with the bank that the bank will lease to you its share of the musharka. Its share. Partnership or joint venture, and ijara means leasing. After you enter into musharka with the bank and after the project has been completed, suppose you own of this project 50%. You will ask the bank if the bank is willing to lease to you its share of the project. Means you will be lessee and the bank will be lessor. In this case, you own 50% of the project as owner, and 50% you don't own, but you lease it from the bank. The whole project will be with you because it is your project and you are interested and you carried feasibility study and you know that this project is promising and it is good. The bank will tell you, okay, keep it for you. I am ready to lease my share to you. And then you keep the whole project with you for a fixed period. What is more than this? Very innovative and very good. And it suits many, many businessmen. That is musharka mutanaqsa. What is diminishing musharka? Mutanaqsa means diminishing musharka. What is that? You enter with the bank into musharka. You pay your capital, your contribution. The bank will pay its contribution. Let us assume that the capital of this musharka is 100 and your contribution is 50. And the bank contribution is 50. Means you own 50% of the shares of this musharka, of this partnership. You have 50 units, or say 50 shares of this partnership. And the bank has 50 units, or 50 shares of this musharka. Why? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome you back to the Islamic financial system. We were talking about the musharka under Islamic law and Islamic Sharia. From where you will pay the price of this 50%? From your profit. This is the agreement. bank will agree with you that when you get profit, you will pay your profit, share of profit to the bank to get from the bank its share. Every time, periodically, maybe every year, every 6 months, then you are saving from your profit share. Instead of having your profit share, you agree with the bank that this will be given to the bank, and the bank will sell to you its share of this partnership. You may get little profit just for your life. You may need it and give the remaining, the balance, give it to the bank for to purchase this units of the bank. That is why most, maybe 99% of those who came to the Islamic Bank to enter into Musharka, شركة عقد, contractual Musharka, or شركة ملك, co-ownership, they end with owning, with having the whole project. In all cases, when you make Musharka with the bank, at the end, you will be the owner of the project. Being any kind of project, if it is real estate project, if it is trade, if it is manufacturing, if it is agricultural project, then you come to the bank with seeking some financing, and at it end with the bank giving you the finance, and at the end you will own the project. This is something I consider it as miracle of this Islamic financial system. If you compare it with the conventional banks, and you will be responsible to pay back the loan with the interest regardless of the result of your project. Suppose in this case I am talking about, instead of having Musharka with the Islamic Bank, you have seen Musharka. What will be the result? You will be partner, you will be owner of part of the asset, and you will get share of the profit as agreed. You will get incentive, you will get fees and everything. And if there is no, in Musharka, if there is no profit, say, you will not pay anything to the bank because the bank gets share of the profit if there is a profit. But in conventional bank, can you tell the conventional bank from whom you get loan, I'll not pay the interest because I don't have profit? Never, never. He will not listen to you. You should pay the interest. The bank doesn't care if you make profit or you don't make profit. The bank has guarantees, has mortgage, has collaterals, has guarantor. If you don't pay the interest, the bank will sell, will liquidate your assets and will get the interest. No mercy at all. But according to Islamic Musharka, if the project does not give profit, the bank will never ask you to give profit. If there is a loss, total loss, beyond your control, you are not responsible for, the bank will not ask you to pay the capital to the bank, Islamic bank, never. This big difference, Islamic bank will get from you share of the profit if there is a profit. If there is no profit, the bank, Islamic bank, will not get from you any share of the profit. Islamic bank will not ask you to return the capital. Conventional bank, if you get loan from conventional bank for the same project, for the same business, If you don't make profit, you will pay interest. If you make loss, you will pay the capital complete. And if you don't pay, the bank will count, calculate interest. Till such a time, the bank makes sure that it will get its capital plus accumulated interest. Look the difference. That's why Allah consider those who are practicing riba, usury, getting loan with interest or paying interest or receiving interest in war with Allah and His Prophet. فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. This a great sin, because this injustice to humanity, to the one who is needy. Now we have two parties. One has money, surplus. These people who are given the deposits to the conventional banks, they don't need this deposit because they don't need it for their needs. And then they are given loan to the others who don't have money, but they have only their knowledge, their invention. And then they ask them to invest and not to bear any kind of risk. That's why it was a war against Allah and against His Prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, for those who come to know that usury is not riba and interest based transactions are not allowed under Sharia, under Islam, Allah has said to them, فَمَنْ فَلَهُ مَا سَلَفْ. Those who could, after they got this maw'idha, this warning from Allah, and they came to know the Islamic banking, the Islamic financial system, and this Islamic financial system is available for them. And if they come to know this, but they don't refrain from involving themselves in the interest-based transaction, Allah says, فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Means the great sin. They are the owner of hell, as if hell has created for them. This has been addressed to Muslims, to who knows that riba is haram. But let me tell you, nowadays, the whole world is doing Islamic financing. Why? The leading international banks, like Citibank, like HSBC, like Deutsche Bank, ABN AMRO, Swiss Credit, all the leading banks all over the world, they are implementing what I am telling you. They are financing according to Mudaraba, to Istisnaar, to Musharaka. They are doing this. That is why all banks, I am not talking about Islamic banks, but the non-Islamic banks, these are international banks, leading banks all over the world, in Europe, in Russia, in Japan, China, everywhere. Why these banks, instead of loan with interest, why they are using financing through this Islamic Sharia financial modes of financing? Why? Of course. But they believe that this financial system given by Islam is a mercy, is a valid, is good for humanity. That's why they consider it as a gift from Islam to humanity. Because civilization and this gift from Allah is to be for humanity, not only for Muslims. And Muslims are required by Allah to offer to humanity all what they have, this Islamic financial system. You know that many of the banks now, they are converting into Islamic financial institutions because Islam now and the financial system, I think all over the world, education institutions, universities, not only banks, but universities, they are learning, teaching Islam because they believe that Islam and its financial system will be the new world order to save humanity from any ill or disasters. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.